The nation's top office clarified Seoul's position on Washington's request for a meeting to possibly amend the free trade deal. Changhwade touched on the wording of the letter that it does not mean renegotiation. Hwang Ho-jun shares with us their take on the matter.
In response to a letter sent by United States Trade Representative Robert Lighthizer on Thursday morning requesting a special meeting to possibly amend the current free trade agreement between Seoul and Washington, the presidential office of Changhwade once again clarified its position. An official from the presidential office first emphasized that the USTR's letter doesn't use the term renegotiation, but rather amendment or modification. The official said that although the Korean government is aware that the U.S. in fact has a trade deficit with Korea, the two sides must figure out whether such deficit is due to the bilateral trade deal. According to the Blue House, many scholars cite structural problems in Seoul and Washington's economies as the source of the trade deficit in the U.S. The Blue House even said there are contradicting views even within the U.S. on the FTA. While the USTR asserts the trade deficit in goods with Korea has doubled from about 13 billion to nearly 28 billion U.S. dollars, and that its total good exports to Korea declined 2.7% since the FTA went into effect, the Blue House quoted the U.S. International Trade Commission's report that the Korea-U.S. FTA in fact improved bilateral merchandise trade balances by nearly 15.8 billion U.S. dollars in 2015. The official also indicated the possibility of the special meeting being postponed. The Changhwade official said he acknowledges that in principle, the meeting should be convened within 30 days, but he also said an exception can be made if both sides agree. He pointed out that a delay may be necessary due to the vacancy at Korea's top trade post. While Lighthizer's letter was sent to Seoul's current Minister of Trade, Industry and Energy, the current administration is trying to establish a new trade negotiations office headed by a new trade minister via a government reorganization. However, the bill is still sitting idle due to political gridlock at the National Assembly. The official said he believes the U.S. will understand. The presidential office is cautious about jumping into any conclusions. The Blue House official continued to emphasize that such a meeting will not necessarily lead to an amendment of the existing free trade agreement with Washington. Hwang Ho-jun, Arirang News.